Yesterday we were doing some questions based on nature of roots, like prove that for any values of lambda the roots will be different, like all the roots are real and distinct. So all those questions we did, like those were something called as nature of roots. We are basically checking what kind of roots will there be, will there be real and unequal roots, etc., etc. So continuing that topic, we have something called as Rolle's theorem for polynomials. So I'll simply write that as Rolle's theorem. So this is Rolle's theorem for polynomials, remember that, okay? Rolle's theorem. So what does Rolle's theorem state? So this is the statement. The statement is extremely simple. So let fx be a polynomial, with real coefficients. So this is again very, very important here, with real coefficients. Now the Rolle's theorem says that between any two consecutive roots, consecutive real roots of this equation fx equals to 0, there is at least one real root, of the equation f dashed x equals to 0. So this is what Rolle's theorem states. I have some polynomial with real coefficients. So again, this real word is very important. The coefficient cannot be complex numbers. Between any two consecutive real roots of the equation fx equals to 0, there is at least one real root of the equation f dashed x equals to 0. So in our syllabus, only statement is there, but the proof is not very tough. You can just go through the proof if you want to do, but for the timing, I'll be not be doing this. So in the statement, in the syllabus, if you see, they have just said you the statement of Rolle's theorem without the proof, okay? But again, I'll tell you, the proof is extremely simple. You can go through it. I'll just explain what the Rolle's theorem says. So I have some function fx. So suppose it has got two zeros. Suppose the function is something like this. I'm not drawing the function. Suppose one root is alpha, another root is beta. Okay, so between any two consecutive real roots, I'm assuming that these two roots are consecutive. That means there does not exist any root between alpha and beta of fx equals to 0. Then what does Rolle's theorem say? You take this function now, the derivative of the polynomial, then there is at least one root, suppose gamma, lying between alpha and beta. Okay, alpha and beta. So this is a general Rolle's theorem. If you just remember what was Rolle's theorem, that a function is continuous, right? Like, it is just the Rolle's theorem that you have done in your class 12th level only. It is just that in a different language. Like, if you see, fx is my polynomial and consider alpha, beta are the roots. Then you know that f of alpha is 0 and f of beta is also 0. So f of alpha equals to f of beta. This condition is achieved. Then fx being a polynomial, it is continuous everywhere between alpha and beta. You consider this interval. And the derivative also exists in alpha beta. Then by the Rolle's theorem, there exists a point between alpha and beta, suppose gamma, such that the derivative is 0. So this is exactly the same thing written in a different language. Between any two consecutive real roots of fx equals to 0, there is at least one real root of the equation f dash x equals to 0. So this is what Rolle's theorem says. Am I clear with the Rose theorem? So we have a corollary to this. So let me write the corollary to this. So this is again very easy to prove. Between any two consecutive roots, again consecutive real roots, alpha dashed and beta dashed, there is some numbers, I'm just writing them as alpha dashed and beta dashed, of f dashed x equals to 0. So between any two consecutive real roots, alpha dashed and beta dashed of this equation. So this time I am taking two consecutive roots of f dashed x equals to 0. There is either no real root, or at most one real root of the equation fx equals to 0. Okay, now this is at most one real root only means either one real root or no real root. So writing this is makes no sense. I don't know why they have written like this. Okay, anyways, so this is not required to us. So there is at most one real root of the equation fx equals to 0. So now we are like what Rolle's theorem said, between any two consecutive roots of fx equals to 0, there is at least one root of the equation f dashed x equals to 0. But here we have the opposite thing. This time we are considering between two consecutive roots of the derived polynomial, that is the derivative of the polynomial, there is at most one real root of the equation fx equals to 0. Now the question is, why cannot be two? Like why cannot be two real roots between alpha dashed and beta dashed? So the idea is very simple. So suppose alpha dashed and beta dashed are two consecutive real roots of f dashed x equals to 0. This is given to us. My claim is there is at most one real root. That means there cannot be more than one. Right? It can be either one real root or zero real root. But let us suppose that there is two real roots of the equation fx equals to 0 lying between alpha dashed and beta dashed. Suppose one is alpha, another is beta. See, I want to prove there is at most one real root. I'm supposing that suppose there is two real roots of the equation fx equals to 0 lying between alpha dashed and beta dashed. So what will happen? Can anybody tell me if I'm assuming this? Where will, like, what will be the, why it will be a contradiction?
Then there will be one real root of between alpha and beta.
Very good, very good. So
it is a contradicting alpha dash and beta dash.
Very good, very good. Perfect answer. So if I am assuming that suppose there are two real roots alpha and beta lying between alpha dash and beta dash, then by the Rolle's theorem, there is at least one real root lying between alpha and beta. Suppose that real root is gamma, and this gamma will be such that f dashed gamma is 0. By the Rolle's theorem, this gamma is a real root of the derived polynomial, right? But this is a contradiction because I assume that alpha dashed and beta dashed are consecutive. Like after alpha dashed, there is beta dashed. But this contradicts the fact that beta dashed and alpha dashed are consecutive, because after alpha dashed there is gamma. So this is not possible. So there is at most one real root of the equation fx equals 0. They cannot be more than one. So either zero real root or one real root, but not more than that. So I will not write the proof. I have already given you the idea of the proof. You can straightforward write it down. Okay, you just write down, suppose that alpha dashed and beta dashed are two consecutive real roots of f dash x equals to 0. Assume that alpha dashed less than beta dashed. Suppose there are two real roots of fx equals to 0 lying between alpha dashed and beta dashed. So by Rolle's theorem, you write down there is exists at least one real number gamma such that f dash gamma is 0, and that contradicts the fact that alpha dashed and beta dashed are consecutive. So there is at most one real root. They cannot be two. So there is at most one. So this is also done. What else? Just a minute. Let's see what can be done next. So another corollary is this. So I'll write this as corollary 2. So this is again very much important. If all the all the roots of this equation fx equals to 0 are real and distinct. So remember, I am assuming that all the roots of fx equals to 0 are real and distinct. Then all the roots of f dashed x are also real and distinct. So this is what is so important. Okay. So basically, suppose I have some polynomial equation fx equals to 0, and I am assuming that suppose this equation has all its roots real and distinct. So all the roots of the equation fx equals to 0 are real as well as they are all different numbers. Then this will also happen for the derived polynomial. So then all the roots of this equation f dashed x equals to 0 are also real and distinct. The proof is very simple. How will you start? Suppose the degree of my equation is n, and suppose alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha n are all distinct real roots of this equation. So all these things I have to write. Okay. So let fx equals to 0 be an equation of degree n, and suppose alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha n. Okay. Where I'm just assuming that I have arranged them in ascending order. Alpha n. This I can do it. I'll find all the roots. I'll arrange them in ascending order, and then I'll name alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha n. So where this are the distinct real roots, of fx equals to 0. So this I am assuming. That is, I have to assume, you see, all the roots of this are real and distinct. Now, this is just an application of Rolle's theorem. Alpha, between alpha 1 and alpha 2, there will lie a root of f dashed x equals to 0 by the Rolle's theorem. Between alpha 2 and alpha 3, there lies a root of f dashed x equals to 0. So, this I'll write that down. This is just by this Rolle's theorem. So, there are n minus 1 intervals. You see, why n minus 1 intervals? So there are n minus 1 intervals. The first interval is alpha 1 to alpha 2. This one. The second is alpha 2 to alpha 3. The third one is alpha 3 to alpha 4. And so on. The last interval is alpha n minus 1 to alpha n. And you see that you do the counting. 1, 2, 3. 3 and then n minus 1. So there are n minus 1 intervals, okay, each containing a real root of f dashed x equals to 0 by the Rolle's theorem. This is guaranteed by Rolle's theorem. Okay, so it is very easy up to here that I'm assuming that there are n many roots which are real and distinct. Consider this n minus 1 intervals. Inside this interval, there lies at least one real root of the equation f dash x equals to 0. This is guaranteed by the Rolle's theorem. Okay. Now you tell me, Rolle's theorem is guaranteed that there is at least n minus 1 roots of f dash x equals to 0. Because this has a root, this has a root, this has a root, and so on, this has a root. So how many intervals are there? N minus 1 intervals are here. That means there will be at least n minus 1 real roots of f dash x equals to 0. But what is the degree of f dash x equals to 0?
N minus 1.
So there will be exactly n minus 1 real roots of the equation f dash x equals to 0. So that I'll write, since the degree of f dash x equals to 0 is n minus 1. Okay, these n minus 1, which n minus 1? This n minus 1 real roots are all the roots of f dashed x equals to 0. So this is what the theorem says. If I have some equation whose all the roots are real and distinct, then all the roots of the derived polynomial will also be real and distinct. So this is very, very important. So this completes the proof. So what does this corollary state? That if I have some equation having all its roots as real and distinct, and all the roots of f dash x equals to 0 are also real and distinct. Now this may not be the case all the time. Like, I cannot have an equation having all its roots real and distinct. So how can we generalize this theorem? That means, suppose I have some equation fx equals to 0 having, suppose, r many real roots. Here all the roots are real and distinct, but I am assuming that, suppose I have some equation which has got r real roots. That means the degree I am assuming is n, the degree of the equation is n, and suppose there are r many real roots, r is strictly less than n, suppose. Okay, and the roots may be repeated as well. Suppose 2 is repeated 3 times, 5 is repeated 7 times, and so on. Then what can you say about the roots of the derived polynomial in that case? So basically, we are more or less generalizing this theorem, okay, to a more general condition. So let me state the theorem first of all very precisely. Generalize the previous theorem or the previous corollary. So the next theorem is what I just stated right now. Okay, let fx be a polynomial of degree, I am not assuming the degree, still I am suppose saying degree n. Let fx be a polynomial of degree n with real coefficients. Okay, suppose I have this thing. If fx equals to 0 has r real roots if fx equals to 0 has got r real roots, and I am not assuming that this r real roots are distinct, remember that they may be repeated and so on. Okay, so if fx equals to 0 has got r real roots, then the number of real roots of f dashed x equals to 0 is at least r minus 1. So we have generalized the previous corollary into like this. So if my equation fx equals to 0 has r real roots, the number of real roots of the equation f dashed x equals to 0 is at least r minus 1. Now, before going to the proof, suppose it has got n real roots. N real roots. Then the number of real roots of f dashed x equals to 0 is at least n minus 1. And because this has degree n minus 1, so it will have exactly n minus 1 roots. Okay, real roots. So the previous corollary can also be derived from this theorem as well. Because instead of r, if I am taking here n, it will say n minus 1, and hence we are done. Right, and at least will be changed into exactly, because this cannot have more than n minus 1 roots. Okay, but we are doing in general. Okay, so this would be again very much useful to us. And the proof is again very simple enough. So let me write down the hypothesis. What is given in the question? This has been given in the question, right? Fx equals to 0 has r real roots. But remember, I have nowhere written that this r real roots are distinct. They may be same also. Like suppose this root has been repeated 5 times, another root has been repeated 3 times. I'm talking about multiple roots. So that may also happen. So let me write all those things. So let alpha 1, alpha 2, ... alpha s. Remember that. I'm not taking here alpha r. If I'm writing here alpha r, I'm assuming that they are all distinct. But I'm not writing that. I'm just assuming that alpha 1, alpha 2, ... alpha s be the distinct real roots of fx equals to 0 with respective multiplicities m1, m2, ... ms. This I am assuming. That means, suppose I have an equation which has root 1, 5 and minus 3 as roots, and this is required repeated 2 times, this is repeated 1 time, this is repeated suppose 3 times. Then this alpha 1 is 1, alpha 2 is 5, alpha 3, that is here alpha s, will be minus 3, the last one. And m1 is 2, m2 is 1, m3 or ms is 3. So alpha 1 is repeated m1 number of times, alpha 2 is repeated m2 number of times, ... alpha s is repeated ms number of times. Then what is the relation between this? Then m1 plus m2 ... ms. Who can tell me what is this?
This is R, sir.
Very good. This is R. The answer is very simple, because I am assuming there are R real roots. So here, how many real roots are there? There are 6 real roots are there, if I count them with their multiplicities. So, because in my theorem, the hypothesis says that fx equals to 0 has R real roots. So m1 plus m2 plus ms will be R. So this I'll be requiring a bit later for my purpose. Okay, so this should be required, and this is very essential. Okay, Now, without loss of generality, suppose I'm not like, I'm just assuming that they are in ascending order. I can always assume that. I can just keep this here, then one here, and then five here, and change this accordingly, and this happens. So I may assume that without changing the proof or without hampering the general proof. Okay, so without loss of generality, assume this happens. I have arranged these roots in the ascending order. So I'm assuming that alpha 1 is the smallest real root and alpha s is the largest real root. Okay. Again, the usual same thing by the Rolle's theorem. Here there lies a root. Between alpha 2 to alpha 3, there lies a root. Alpha s minus 1 to alpha s, there lies a root. This is by the Rolle's theorem. Okay, so same thing. So each of the s minus 1 intervals alpha 1 to alpha 2, alpha 2 to alpha 3, dot dot dot, alpha s minus 1 to alpha s. So each of these intervals contains at least one real root of fx equals to 0. Okay, sorry, f dashed x equals to 0. This is guaranteed by the Rolle's theorem. This is guaranteed by the Rolle's theorem. Okay. So therefore, this one is again important. So idea is again very simple. Each of this interval will contain at least one root, one real root of the equation f dashed x equals to 0. So this is guaranteed by the Rolle's theorem. So this has a root of f dashed x equals to 0. This has a root of f dashed x equals to 0. So I can guarantee that there is at least s minus 1 real roots of the equation f dashed x equals to 0. Thus, I'll write that. Therefore, we have at least s minus 1 distinct roots of the equation f dashed x equals to 0. This is guaranteed for sure. Now, we had done a theorem, if you remember. If alpha 1 is a root of the equation fx equals to 0 with the multiplicity m1, then alpha 1 is also a root of the equation f dashed x equals to 0 with multiplicity m1 minus 1. You remember this theorem we had done? You can just check the notes and see. So I had done a theorem, if alpha is a root of the equation fx equals to 0 with multiplicity m, then alpha is also a root of the equation f dashed x equals to 0 having multiplicity m minus 1. Remember this theorem or no? You may just check your copies where I have taught multiplicities or multiple roots. So again I'll write. So moreover, I'll write the same thing which I said. So I have this many roots for sure. So moreover, alpha 1 is a root of f dashed x equals to 0 of multiplicity. I'll simply write, due to lack of space, I'll write am. Am in multiplicity, arithmetic multiplicity, m1 minus 1. Alpha 2 is a root of f dashed x equals to 0 of am m2 minus 1 and dot dot dot. Alpha s is a root of f dashed x equals to 0 of multiplicity ms minus 1. See, this minus 1 is different, not below. Okay, so ms minus 1 m2. Understood up to here or no? So let us count the roots, number of real roots of this one. F dash x equals to 0. So it is at least s minus 1 plus m1 minus 1 plus m2 minus 1 plus dot 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 ms minus 1. So these many real roots will definitely exist for f dash x equals to 0. S minus 1 is here and this many are here. So let's count all the real roots of f dash x equals to 0. So thus there are, I'll not write like this, thus number of real roots of f dashed x equals to 0 is at least equal to s minus 1 plus m1 minus 1 plus m2 minus 1 plus dot 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 ms minus 1. So this is guaranteed that it has got this many roots. So this is s minus 1 plus, let's see what happens here. I'll take all this m's together, that means m1 plus m2 plus dot 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 ms, right? How many ones are here? Forget this one. How many ones are here? Can anybody tell me? How many ones are here? Just here. Okay. Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, how many times? So how many ones are here? This minus 1, minus 1, dot dot dot, minus 1, s times, right? So minus s. I'm adding minus 1, s many times, right? So this s and this s got cancelled. And what was this? You remember m1 plus m2 plus ms, this was nothing but r. I have made a box in the previous page. This is nothing but r. Okay, so this is nothing but r. So this becomes r and this I have r minus 1. So what I have got? There's a number of real roots of f dash x equals to 0 is at least r minus 1. And this is what I was supposed to prove. And this completes the proof. So remember what I have done till now. I did Rolle's theorem. What did Rolle's theorem told us? That between any two roots of fx equals to 0, there is at least one real root of f dashed x equals to 0. Okay, definitely I'm talking about real roots. The first corollary that we did, between any two real roots of f dashed x equals to 0, definitely consecutive ones, there is at most one real root of the equation fx equals to 0. And the second corollary said that if all the roots of f dashed equals to 0, if all the roots of fx equals to 0 are real and distinct, then so is for f dashed x. That means all the roots of f dashed x are also real and distinct. And the last theorem that we did, which is here, which stated that if fx equals to 0 has r real roots, then there is at least r minus 1 real roots for the equation f dashed x equals to 0. So I will do this much for today. These are the theorems based on nature of roots, which will help us to determine the nature of roots. And then in the next class, I will discuss about the sums based on these theorems. Okay, so that's all for today. If you have any doubts, feel free to ask. Thank you.